the mystical experience or peak experience is puzzling in that some people have them, their lives are like reoriented, and some people have them on Saturday afternoon and go back to work on Monday being thinking, oh, that was like a weird movie I saw. And the change that often happens is a change in motivation when it happens. I think the thing to say is that there are triggers for mystical experiences that sometimes work and sometimes don't. And they include meditation, contemplative prayer, and psychedelics, and so forth. And sometimes they produce mystical experiences, and sometimes they don't. And sometimes people have mystical experiences, change their motivation, and sometimes they don't. So it's a sometimes chain of events as it goes along. And the big thing that seems to happen to, well, one of the big things, is a change in motivation from being self-motivated and sort of living your life like, what do I get out of, what's in it for me, to what are my responsibilities to my family or to all of humanity or to the cosmos. So during a peak experience or mystical experience, one of the things that happens is a transcendence of the ego. That's where the word transpersonal comes in transpersonal psychology. And so you move from ego motivation to transpersonal motivation, in which you see your ego as sort of a helpful temporary way to be. I mean, we have to do the things that the ego lets us do, but we should use the ego in the same sense like we use a coat or a pair of shoes. We should identify with a coat or pair of shoes. Alan Watts has a videotape called The Self, A Case of Misidentification, and that says it very nicely. So we find people having non-egoic motivations, like how can I help humanity, or what's good for the environment, or you know, these broader concerns that happen. And this is not just from psychedelics, but this is a common effect of mystical experiences. And so psychedelic mystical experiences just fit within that observation.